You know, when I was a student starting, I was kind of told that the Center of Limnology and this Trout Lake Station was a big deal kind of worldwide. But at the time, I didn't know. Wisconsin was my world, and I didn't really know. This is the founding place of limnology in the world. That's kind of humbling, just to realize that these, you know, fathers we have in limnology kind of started here.
We were really excited to be able to celebrate the 100-year anniversary of Trout Lake Station this summer. A key element was to bring people together. People who work at the station now, a lot of our colleagues, collaborators, partners, but also folks who have worked at the station in the past. So it was an opportunity to bring together all different groups, past, present, and future, to connect and to celebrate the things that have been accomplished. One exciting thing about this event was that we had people who had done research at Trout Lake Station spanning 8 decades.
Putting faces to names of people that were here 40 years ago that I have been hearing about for all the years that I've been up here is really fun. Having read their papers and seen their research, it's a really fun group of people and very good group to work with. Everybody who's come through here kind of feels a really strong sense of community and kind of it being a second home. And that's something that I felt very early on too, and what led me to keep coming back and to pursue being able to work here full time.
Trout Lake Station serves many roles. One is that it provides an opportunity for researchers down here in Madison to conduct their research up in the Northwoods. And so it serves UW-Madison and researchers who are based here who want to work on these questions. It also serves researchers from a wide range of other universities within the UW system and beyond. So it serves the research community. But Trout Lake Station itself doesn't just serve researchers. Trout Lake Station has its own researchers who are really engaged in the local community. So they live in the area, and their research is very much connected into the needs of the local people. So that area is really driven by water and lakes. There are lakes everywhere, several thousand lakes within an hour drive of Trout Lake Station. And so lakes are really, really critical in people's lives.
I come to tears because I feel so much, it's hard to find the words for it, but just you feel this in your soul, like this is a good place to be, and it's the relationships, but it's also the nature. And so to like all of us be here and feel that and celebrate it together is really cool.
I think a big conversation at this event was, where are we going? Where will we be 100 years from now? I think that's a critical question. One thing we want to make sure is that Trout Lake Station is there and as strong as ever 100 years from now. What do we want to be doing 100 years from now? Well, we want to expand our ability to be connected in the community with other organizations and people who care about lakes. So as we try to manage our lakes in this rapidly changing world, we need cutting edge science that's going to inform how we manage lakes. And Trout Lake Station is where that research happens.